Beverly Hills Club first opened, we were one of a kind around here. And you know what? Today, we still are. Let me show you around. With 12 boutiques under one roof, here's our new Pilates studio, indoor pool, and state-of-the-art fitness floor. Kids room. We have nearly 200 classes weekly, including TRX, yoga, spinning. It's all geared just waiting for you. Join now with zero enrollment. Everyone pays half rate. Plus, get up to an $800 bonus. Call 248-642-8500. Now, we are not done with the snow, and we could still be seeing some accumulation in spots to show you who's under the gun. Coming up. Oh.
So what do you think is the net effect of even the talk of a looming government shutdown? Well, let's talk to some of the businesses and the people who depend on these contracts.
Face to face, sharp words pierce the silence of a Lansing courtroom.
There were none. Coming up tonight at 5 on 7 Action News, we actually hear from more victims of Larry Nassar, as well as one who says that MSU was complicit in this, and she directly addresses their absence in the courtroom today.
Certainly a lot of people watching this case, really all across the nation. Thank you so much, Brian, for the live report. Joanne?
Carolyn, now this unspeakable tragedy in northern Oakland County, where a deadly fire claimed the lives of a family of four. The flames ripped through the home of Brittany Roden and John Tablou in Rose Township overnight. Both were killed, including their two young boys. This is a picture now of the victims on Brittany's Facebook page. People are posting about the loss and sending their condolences. We've learned that fire crews responded to this trailer on Wakewood Court at about 5:30 this morning. When they arrived, the home was engulfed in flames with the family still trapped inside. Sadly, again, they did not survive. Two others in the home were able to escape, and they're being treated at area hospitals.
They
saw the flames. They say, rather, they were a huge challenge with limited hydrants in the area, and dozens of firefighters were needed to battle the fire. Coming up on 7 Action News at 5, Kim Russell is talking with investigators about how they think that fire started.
With snow hanging on around Metro Detroit today, and people still have to take it easy out there on the roads right now. This is a live look over downtown Detroit. You can see that snow is still coming down right now. But we want to know about this evening for the commute home. 7 First Alert meteorologist Kevin Jean joins us right now. So, Kevin, a lot of people are saying no.